ignore you for a while and turn my attention to the people whose achievements we are here to celebrate. It's not that I intend to ignore you for good. Don't worry, I will be back to you in a few minutes. Graduates, this is your day, and we are here to salute you. Now, this is an auditorium full of stories. Your stories. If only we had time to tell them all, they would together outdo anything that I could ever say. Stories about your passions and determination, the opportunities you missed and those that you seized, the barriers that were thrown in your path and the way you dismantled, the fun and the frustration, the stumbles and the race to the finish. If we could only weave a tapestry from those stories, it would be of the richest colours and the most intricate design. And people would travel miles to see it. Close up, they would find all your stories and be fascinated. And then, as they step back to take in the whole glorious piece, out of the finely wrought detail, slowly into focus, would emerge one defining image. An image of achievement. One person, standing tall in a blue gown, gazing down at the spectators, as if to say, I did it. Step back now to the moment that the prospect of being an Open University student floated into your mind. It may have been 3 years, 6 years, or further back still than that. Before you entrusted your hopes and dreams to the OU, I hope you asked some simple but telling questions about whether the OU could help you to weave the story that you wanted to tell about yourself. Question one, does the OU do a good job for its students? Well, if you want to know the truth about any university, ask its students. For the past 5 years, that's happened in almost every university in the UK through the government's National Student Survey. And in each year, the OU has come in the top three for overall student satisfaction. Here in Northern Ireland, the OU has been the top achieving provider for student satisfaction in 2 of the last 3 years.
Tablet. Yes, sir. Belfastiani siamo tutti così.